Hi guys, in this video I'm going to teach you how to insert annotative dimensions. Even if you didn't understand yet the difference between standard and annotative, you will learn it in the next few minutes. So, if I use annotative dimension lines, they will appear in the paper with the same size, even if we have viewports in different scales, like here. So, first of all, I will click in the tab Annotate, and in the dimension section, I click in this little arrow here to open the dimension style manager. Here I will click on the annotative style, and I will click in Modify to edit it. Now we are in the section text, and we can see here the text height, which is set up as 3 mm. As this is a good size for viewing in the paper, I will not change it. Then I go to symbols and arrows, and also the arrow size has 3, which is good for me. So I can click in OK. Now close. OK, now I can start. But before, I will show you a new tip, which is available since AutoCAD 2016. So I'm going to type DIMLAYER, press enter, and I have to insert the name for a new layer which I want the dimension lines in, for example dimensions. And by doing this, every time I create a new dimension line, it goes automatically to that layer. So let's start drawing annotative dimensions. First, I want to draw these two dimensions here, and this viewport is in a scale of 1 per 100. So the first thing I have to do is to change the scale in this icon and select 1 per 100. Now I can type dim linear or click in the icon over there, press enter, and I'm going to draw the dimension line here. I click in the first point and now in the second point. But as you see, the text here is very small, and it happened because I forgot to change the current dimension style. So going back, I can change the style here and select annotative. Now it should be fine. So I click in the first point and the second point, and I place it here. For the next, I press enter to reactivate the previous command. Now I click in this point, and now the second, and here it is. So if we go now to the layout, you can see that the arrows and the text are visible, and when I print, the text and the arrows height will be exactly 3 mm, as it is what I specified before. Now let's draw the lines which are in the viewport with scale 1 per 30. So what do you think I should do? It's simple. Do the same process. I have to change the scale to 130. Now I will draw again the dimension line here, and then I will draw these other two here. When I zoom out to see all the drawing, you can notice that the dimensions I just made are much smaller than the other ones. But in fact, if I go to the layout, you can see that they have the same size in both viewports. I also need to tell you another thing. You cannot see the dimensions here, because as I drew them in a scale of 1 per 30, they will only appear in the viewport that has the same scale, which is this one in the right. Now, the last thing I want to talk about in this video, it's very important, are these icons here about annotation objects. The first one here that says show annotation objects. If it's switched on, all my annotation lines are displayed in the drawing. Now I'm going to deactivate it and look what happened. The dimension lines I have there disappeared, and the only ones that you can see were made with the scale that appears here, which is 130. So if I change to 100, you will see only the other ones. Okay, so thank you very much for watching. I hope now the annotative dimensions are clear for you. And if you haven't done it yet, don't forget to subscribe my channel to get full access to all the tutorials. So thank you very much and see you next time.